Tonight, police are searching for suspects after a man was gunned down in the daylight near a busy playground in Waverly. Shots were fired at the intersection of 34th Street and Ellerslie Avenue around 5 o'clock tonight. The crime scene is sandwiched between an elementary school, a child care center, and that playground. 11 News reporter Carrie Cavanaugh is live at police headquarters downtown. She has the details for us. Carrie?
Police tell us that the victim did survive his injuries, but they do add that those injuries were so severe he was shot in the head, and now homicide detectives are taking over the investigation. Meanwhile, the shooter is on the loose, and naturally, many people in Waverly are on edge. The site where Memorial Stadium used to sit was bustling early Tuesday evening. Families packed Waverly Stadium Place playground when gunfire broke out across the street around 5 p.m.
Who knows what could have happened to any of the kids on the playground?
It's terrible. I mean, they can't even play without, it could have been a stray bullet.
The violence was confined to the corner of Ellerslie Avenue and 34th Street, where police found a man in his 30s slumped over the wheel of this black car, suffering from a gunshot wound to the head.
Possibly one shooter approached him on foot, shot him, and then fled from the scene.
Parents we spoke to, including some who heard the shots, were unnerved but chose to stay put on the playground.
We still stayed and played, which probably wasn't the safer thing to do, but we did, because I didn't want the kids to, I didn't want to have to leave with the kids, and they cried.
I've lived in this neighborhood, in the Waverly neighborhood for a while now, and things like this, happen every so often. It's a shame. It's just an example of senseless violence.
And parents add, a disturbing example for the kids who come here to have fun. And police, of course, canvassed the area looking for any witnesses. They're also checking footage from nearby crime cameras to see if they may have picked up any clues. Meanwhile, they have not released a description of the gunman. However, they do tell us at this point they believe it was one person working alone, but they're not sure why he may have targeted the victim. Reporting live downtown, I'm Carrie Cavanaugh, WBAL-TV 11 News.